This is question number 8 of exercise 5.6 from the chapter Continuity and Differentiability. The question is, find dy by dx without eliminating the parameter when the parametric function which is given to us is x is equal to a into cos t plus log 10 t by 2 and y is equal to a sin t, and you can see that t is the parameter. Okay, now to solve this question, first of all we take x, and because x and y both depends on the parameter t, so we are going to differentiate this equation with respect to t. So we are going to get dx by dt as equal to d by dt of a into cos t plus log 10 t by 2. Okay, so we get dx by dt as equal to a into d by dt of cos t plus d by dt of log 10 t by 2. Now d by dt of cos t would be equal to minus sin t. Okay, and d by dt of log 10 t by 2 would be equal to 1 upon 10 t by 2 into d by dt of 10 t by 2. Okay, so we are going to get dx by dt as equal to a into minus sin t plus a into 1 by 10 t by 2 into d by dt of 10 of t by 2. So this a is multiplied with both the terms after opening the bracket. Okay, further I can write this as equal to minus a sin t, this value as it is, and d by dt of 10 of t by 2 is equal to sec square t by 2 into d by dt of t by 2. And further d by dt of t by 2 would be equal to 1 by 2 because d by dt of t would be 1. Okay, now further I am going to simplify this term. So for this I have written this 10 t by 2 as sin t by 2 upon cos t by 2. So I get this as equal to cos t by 2 upon sin t by 2. And sec square t by 2 is written as 1 upon cos square t by 2 into 1 by 2. This cos t by 2 whole square cancels out. Okay, so I get this as equal to minus a sin t plus a into 1 by 2 sin t by 2 cos t by 2. So this would be equal to sin t, because 2 sin a cos a is equal to sin 2a. So I get this as equal to minus a sin t plus a upon sin t. Or taking a common, I get this as equal to a into minus sin t plus 1 upon sin t, or this as equal to a into minus sin square t plus 1 upon sin t on taking LCM. 1 minus sin square t is equal to cos square t. Okay, so I get dx by dt as equal to a cos square t upon sin t. Okay, and further y is equal to a sin t is given to us, therefore dy by dt is equal to a into d by dt of sin t, or simply a cos t. So dy by dx is equal to dy by dt whole upon dx by dt. So placing the value of dy by dt and dx by dt, I get this as equal to a into cos t whole upon a into cos square t upon sin t. So a cancels out, the sin t is going to go in the numerator, one of the cos is going to cancel out. So that is, we can cancel square and remove this cos t. So I'm going to get sin t upon cos t, which is equal to 10 t. So dy by dx is equal to 10 t, which is the required answer. This is question number 9 of exercise 5.6 from the chapter Continuity and Differentiability. The question is, find dy by dx without eliminating the parameter, and the function given in the parametric form is x is equal to a sec theta and y is equal to b tan theta. So we have to find dy by dx without eliminating this parameter theta. Now to solve this question, first of all we take x, which is equal to a sec theta, and because the parameter here is theta, so we are going to differentiate x with respect to theta. So I can write dx by d theta as equal to d by d theta of a sec theta, or dx by d theta would be equal to a sec theta into 10 theta. Similarly, y is equal to b tan theta, so we are going to differentiate this equation, that is y is equal to b tan theta with respect to theta. So I am going to get dy by d theta is equal to d by d theta of b tan theta. We know that differentiation of tan theta with respect to theta is equal to sec square theta. So dy by d theta would be equal to b sec square theta. So dy by dx would be equal to dy by d theta whole upon dx by d theta, and placing the value of dy by d theta as equal to b sec square theta and dx by d theta as a sec theta into 10 theta, So this sec, this square and this sec theta is going to cancel out. So I'm going to get this as equal to b upon a sec theta upon tan theta, or b into 1 upon cos theta whole upon a into sine theta upon cos theta. That is writing sec theta is equal to 1 by cos theta and tan theta as sine theta upon cos theta. So this cos and this cos are going to cancel out. So I'm going to get this as equal to b upon a sine theta or b upon a cosec theta as the value of dy by dx, which is the required answer. Friends, thanks for watching my video. To watch more of these super videos and for the latest updates, subscribe and like the videos on these channels on YouTube, HSK Shiksha and Math Help by HSK. Thank you.